So I've come out to a forest called Rold Forest, and I'm in an area which is literally called the Troll Forest. And one can easily see why with all these twisted old beech trees. They are like quite beautiful. It's quite a popular place, so there are usually quite a lot of people around here in the daytime. But here in the morning, well, I've seen two people who were out trying to find out where north is. I don't know. So my original plan was to go to a forest I was in my Tales from the Forest 3 video. But it was just like overcast and there was no fog or anything. Even though the forecast predicted that that would be the best place to be, I just had to abandon it and give this forest a shot instead. So sadly, I was here way after sunrise, which was of course annoying because the conditions this morning has just been perfect. And I have only had like 15 minutes and it has probably been way better before I arrived. Luckily, there is still a tiny amount of moist left in the air, and it is enough for me to be able to catch some sunstreaks coming down through the trees. So right now I put on the long lens and I'm trying to isolate this very, very simple scene with just like one big branch caught in the light from the sun. And it's kind of hard because moving just a slight inch to the right or left, maybe not an inch, but a meter or so, actually makes quite a significant difference to the scene. And yeah, so it's just about moving a little bit back and forward and see how it ends up. At least for now, I'm going for that super, super minimal mood and composition. Just, it's mainly just about catching the light beams and all the streaks through the scene. All the tree trunks and then the sunbeams coming down through it. It's very beautiful. So sadly, I didn't have much time to do some actual photography. The sun came up and the fog and moist in the air disappeared rather fast. So yeah, you can't win them all, but there are a few pictures that I think worked out and you can see them here. As you can see, I did manage to get a few photos upon arrival, but I only had a few minutes to get them, hence I was quite skeptical whether or not I had even got a photo that I liked. As it turned out, I am actually quite happy with what I got, considered how fast I had to work. Besides getting some misty morning photos, my other objective this morning was to try out my new tripod, so the next segment of this video is all about that. It is not a conclusive review of the tripod, but rather a presentation of and me sharing some initial thoughts on it, as I haven't had enough time to get to know it. So, as you can see, I've got myself a new tripod, and it is one of the Mark III models from Benro. The full model name I'll just put here. It's not like they're very good at naming their tripods. This one here is way bigger than my small travel angel, and as much as I love my travel angel, since I've got my 100-400 from Sony, and even with the 2x extender so I can go all the way out to 800mm, I needed something which were a bit more sturdy. This one here is not the biggest tripod that Benro makes, but it is up there. I think it's the second largest line. So full disclosure, I'm not paid by Benro to say anything good or bad about this tripod, but I have a good relationship with them. So they did ship this one over here for me to try it out and see if it is more sturdy than my travel angel. So I'm looking very much forward to try it out. If you are not a big fan of center columns and you want to get your tripod all the way down to the ground, it does come with an interchangeable center column so that you can use this short one instead, which gives you much more flexibility with the tripod if you want to get down low. If you want to attach spikes, it's quite easy to take off these feet here, rubber feet, and then just put on the spikes instead. I haven't brought the spikes, I've actually never used spikes, but if you're into spikes, you have that option. Another part I really enjoy about my Benro tripods here are the twist locks. You actually only have to twist them like quarter of a diameter of the leg before it's loose, and the same for locking it down again. Also, the handles, the twist locks themselves, are so big. It's so comfortable. It's rubber, so they don't get too cold, and they're just like, they're there, like you can feel them, you can grab them. And that just makes such a big difference to other non-Benro tripods that I have used. The build functions are just about the same as with my smaller tripod. This is just a bigger version. And as you can see here, if you want to move the legs, you simply just take this one out. There's no spring in it, so you have to do it manually, push it in and out. And well, I haven't tried too many other big tripods. For me, this works fine. Now, the only thing I'm not sure if I regret or not is that I chose the version where it has like four sections. I should probably have gone for the one with three sections, because as these are quite big here, the twist knobs, I can use my entire hand to unlock them at once, but then I will have to lock three when I lock it again before it's ready. And you have to do that with all three legs when you unfold it. I think that with two twist locks, it would have made a substantial difference in the amount of time it takes to set it up. So that is definitely worth considering. On a morning like this with absolutely zero wind, there is no reason to use this one here over the Travel Angel when it comes to sturdiness. However, as you can see, this one here is way taller than my Travel Angel, so there is definitely benefits when it comes to the ergonomics of the tripods. You can see fully extended, it is quite tall and probably also completely overkill for me. But if you do have a camera which have a flip screen, then you can actually use the entire height of the tripod. In case you need to level your tripod, there is also a built-in leveling indicator. I'm not sure what that's called in English. In case the tripod isn't sturdy enough, there is also this hook where you can put your camera back or something other which is heavy. If you so decide, you can choose to also get the ball head at the same time as you get the tripod. The ball head, the B3 model here, comes with what you can expect: a panning knob and a tightening knob, which I usually don't use. I just have it on the lightest here. And then just the regular locking knob. And there's a good friction in it, even though it's like completely unlocked. So yeah, it's a ball head. It's like, it's not rocket science, it works. So I'm looking forward to use this one here even more. This is not going to be a substitute for my traveling tripod. My traveling tripod will still be the one I bring out for traveling. But I will use this one here more in Denmark. I might share more thoughts about this one here in the future, or make actually a comparison video between the small tripod and the big tripod. I promise you, I will figure out how to make that an interesting video. So, even though there weren't much photography in this video, I hope you enjoyed it anyway. If you are interested in composition, be sure to get my ebook. There is a link down in the description. And if you're interested in any more of my gear, there is also a complete gear list, almost complete, I think so, also down in the description with affiliate links to both Amazon and B&H. So, as always, I would highly appreciate both a like and a comment, and see you in the next video.